For me, theatre is taking another character and portraying it and feeling what that character feels. I feel like you can't really play a character if you're not willing to. Like, you have to want to feel that character's feelings, and you kind of have to, like, just let yourself go and take that other character.
Our group is called Bayside and Wayside Drama Group, and it's open to students from both schools. We meet every Saturday morning at Bayside Drama Studio, where we carry out drama workshops. We're the only youth drama group in Gibraltar for that age group that offers free drama workshops every Saturday morning. And obviously a big part of that is skills development, so we work a lot on just the kids developing their skills through different activities, through different exercises. And then at some point in the season, we start looking at the festival itself, and we start rehearsing for the festival, start preparing for it. Once that's finished, we're still halfway through the season, so we have another period of workshops. And then in July, we go off to the UK and we take part in festivals there.
Wait, yeah, hopefully he doesn't undo it now.
No, I am good now.
This was really uncomfortable.
This one has a bad impression.
This is my picture, so if anyone needs it, feel free.
Can you all make sure you're all in your full costume?
Come in.
La Calle Comedia was an idea that I've had in my head for a few years, really, you know? And I always liked the thought of telling a local story, but using the genre and the form of Comedia dell'arte. And I found it quite easy to transpose the characters from the original Comedia tradition through to local. It all fit together very, very well.
Us, gentles all, upon this humble stage, to tell thee a story from a different age, a tale of marriage and of affairs of the heart, of boy meets girl and of a love torn apart.
Well, I am basically the narrator of the story. I start the play and I finish it.
Of dukes and of servants, of fathers and daughters, of mistaken identities that muddy the waters, of letters misplaced and of evil intentions, of villains and chases to amp up the tension. But as ever you will see that true love wins the day, and we pray your patience to enjoy our dear play.
Arrived this morning, Dr. Albondigas, delivered to my very door by hand.
By whom?
By hand.
Whose hand?
No, it was delivered in person.
A family from La Línea. We had Don Pantalón, which is the part that I played. He is a miser, and he is from that tradition of Comedia de Pantalone, character who's a miser, always thinking about the best way to make money. And he has been approached by the Duke of Jimena, who is a very unlikable person. And again, he's from the tradition of the villain from Comedia.
The Duke of Jimena himself. It reads thus.
That's a short message.
Don Pantalón, he is meeting with the Duke of Jimena, who I play.
I would appreciate the opportunity to meet you, where it is my intention to ask your daughter for my wife.
And the Duke has an interest in Don Pantalón's daughter, and he wishes to marry her. And it's sort of, you get to see what the family have to go through with this horrid man.
Your daughter's absence, Don Pantalón, while unfortunate, does nevertheless present me with the opportunity to rehearse what I will say to her. Lady Isabella, you are more beautiful than my ass.
What?
Oh, come on, Dom Pantalon. My ass is the envy of the region. So elegant, so muscly, so smooth.
The Duke wants to meet Pantalon in order to marry his daughter, Isabella, who is the female lover from the Commedia tradition.
Darling, darling, Smeraldina, always serving my family, always selflessly sacrificing yourself for us all, and you do this all for nothing but the satisfaction of servitude. That, and minimum wage.
Isabella, she travels with her servant Smeraldina, who is a very kind of a woman of the world. Again, that tradition from the servant, the female servant from Commedia.
But the time of the month when I and all the servants must cross the frontier to Gibraltar to buy supplies. Gibraltar? Yes, my love. The luxurious sweetmeats your father so adores do not buy themselves. Gibraltar.
And they go for a shopping trip to Gibraltar.
My darling daughter, you're just like your mother. Hers was a womb of kindness. And now that you are growing into a lovely young lady, I can see a lot of her in you. I always want to do what's best for you, Isabella. Trust me, I have your best interest in mind.
I know, Father.
Enjoy Gibraltar, Isabella, but be careful.
Of what?
That you don't enjoy it too much.
She basically goes into Gibraltar with her servant and falls in love with this boy.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, yes, of course. Hello.
And how are you?
I'm well, thanks. And you?
I'm very well, thanks.
Oh, good. And how are you?
I'm well, thanks.
This is Master Valerio, my lady. His father owns this warehouse. Oh, how nice. My name is, Isabella. Yes? My mistress's name is Isabella, Master Valerio.
Ah, Isabella for beautiful. For that is what you are.
Isabella meets Valerio, the male lover. Valerio is this heroic, handsome, rugged young man.
What's Valerio?
Oh, Brighella. There's nothing I like more than to stand here on Catalan Bay on a fine morning like this. To hear the waves lapping on the shore, to see the seagulls swooping over the foamy brine, and to smell the fish frying in the restaurants. Oh, can you not breathe that fresh sea air?
You wouldn't want to be doing that in Western Beach, sir.
And they instantly fall in love with each other. But of course, the plot is in place for their relationship to find a lot of obstacles in the form of the Duke.
Allow me to introduce you to the Duke of Ximena.
You may bow.
Pleased to meet you, Your Lordship.
Is this the girl? Okay.
And he's one of those characters who, I guess you could say that he sees Isabella as a sort of, not as a woman, but just someone to have children with. There's a line in the play that pretty much sums up what goes through his mind, but the line is less reading, more breeding, which is not really a nice thing to say, but that pretty much sums up what goes on in his mind.
Those hips don't lie. And progeny is important to a man of my wealth. I am not reassured by modern women. Less reading, more breeding, I say. But I can see that you have raised this young thing quite well. I accept this proposal, and in light of the uniqueness of this catch, I am willing to increase the dowry we discussed earlier to a more substantial sum.
Dowry? Father, just what is going on here?
His Lordship the Duke has asked for your hand in marriage.
What?
You may show your pleasure.
Oh, I'll show you all right.
While also there being another character, Valeria, who's also interested in Isabella, but with that, she is actually in love with him.
The Duke of Ximena, to be his wife and without consulting me! The Duke is but a fraction of the man Valerio is. I will not marry him!
And yet you will! ungrateful? Have I not raised you? Given you everything you've ever needed, loved you more than any father possibly could, for you to defy me thus?
But father!
Enough! It is settled. This evening you will accept the Duke's proposal. You will smile at the prospect of being his wife, and in 7 days' time, you will marry him. Understood?
Father...
I said... Understood?
Yes, Father.
She gives two letters to the servant, Arlecchino, which is me, Don Pantalon's servant, and she says one of them is for the Duke of Ximena, who I don't want to marry, and the other one is for Valerio, who I do.
Good. Now, to ensure there is no confusion, keep the letter for Don Valerio in your right hand, like this. Remember, he is the right man for me. And the letter for the Duke, keep it on your left hand, for he is the one that will be left on his own. Clear?
Crystal, my lady.
Very well. Now, Godspeed, Arlecchino, and fail me not.
Sorry.
Sorry. My apologies, Master Valerio. I bear a letter from my mistress concerning this evening's party.
And basically, Arlecchino, he's not very smart. He's kind of like that stupid servant that doesn't pay attention, and he switches the letters.
Well, where's the letter then?
Well, you're Mr. Right, and this is my right hand, so I guess, I hope. But I must go now, kind sir. I must deliver this letter too, and you know that a slow postal service is not tolerated in these parts.
And gives the wrong one to each character, and then mess.
I write to you to inform you that I desire no further relationship with you. My heart belongs to another man, and to share it with you would be a grievous wrong.
My lady, I am here in a mask up as you requested.
But of course, what happens at the end is, as always with a commedia story, is that the obstacles are overcome, the lovers get together, and everyone gets married, everyone's happy ever after.
First, your daughter leads me on some randy goose chase, and then I get assaulted by this barbary ape of a man in your house. I have a good mind, good sir, to break this engagement off with immediate effect.
I will save you the trouble, your lordship. The wedding's off.
What?
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 My daughter's made her choice. She has chosen Don Valerio.
What? This oath? This bilingual land thief? This galandita eating, tax haven inhabiting, poor excuse of a tobacco smuggler? Why? He's not even rich.
He has my daughter's heart, sir. That makes him the richest man in the world.
I feel like the main message here is that everybody, if it's meant to be, everything will fall into place and everybody ends up happily ever after. But at the same time, the Duke puts on a curse to Gibraltar La Linea.
This is not over, Yanito. You listen to me. I will bring on a curse on your people that will stand the test of time.
But here we introduce a little bit of a different twist, which is just before he gets defeated, the Duke casts a curse on the towns of Gibraltar and La Linea.
And I will not rest until the words Gibraltar Espanol become the slogan of our young. You brought this on your Gibraltarian heads. You may have won Lady Isabella's heart, but it will feel like a hollow victory when the red and yellow flies over the rock you claim to be yours. You mark my words. I'll be revenged on the whole pack of you.
And he promises generations of division. He promises that their communities will be divided through suspicion and through envy. And obviously, that is sadly the history of these two communities, not and the divisions between Gibraltar and the other side of the frontier.
A troubling cloud now follows, hanging over this couple's fate. For wherever there is love, there always lurks hate.
Normally, I create parts
that I really wish I could play myself, and then I don't get the chance and I have to watch students do it better than I would. So it was really good to get a chance to do it myself. And we had so much fun on stage. I think that all of us were really buzzing about how it went. We were all really excited.
The following programme contains scenes that may be upsetting for some viewers.
Whilst we had a very light-hearted comedy with Guy de Comedia, we went for something a lot more hard-hitting in Layla. And this is really where I really stretched the kids, where I really challenged them to try and explore certain aspects of humanity which are quite unpleasant. And in this case, high school shooting. And we wanted to focus on this one character, Layla. We wanted to make the central protagonist a girl, because normally in these high school shootings, the perpetrator is a boy.
My name is Layla. I'm 16 years old, and I'm going to be telling you a story. You've already seen how it ends. It ends with me taking a gun to school and locking myself in a classroom with three other students.
She finds it hard to kind of understand who she is, just as the normal teenager would, and she spends most of the play, trying to discover herself, and she has this best friend called Jessica.
We did everything together. School projects, hanging out during the holidays, make pacts for the future.
So it's settled. If neither of us is married by the time we're 40, we marry each other, okay? We can now, you know, in the state of Massachusetts at least.
So I'm Jared. My character's Oliver, which is Layla's boyfriend.
He's one of those guys. You know, mothers love them, fathers approve. Just a good guy, always bloody teaching.
It's the gyroscoping effect that gives it stability. When you lean, the force steers the handlebars into the direction of the lean, so the center of gravity pretty much stays where it is.
He's more of a supportive character throughout the play. We see how Layla feels happiness when she's with Oliver.
We could just, you know, hang.
That would be good.
And now is when you kiss me.
What?
Kiss me?
She gets bullied a lot in school. She doesn't feel accepted in the world.
And finally, there's Lucy.
My character's called Lucy. Basically, she's Layla's bully. She likes to pick on Layla and make fun of her.
You might want to think about doing your hair, Layla. Maybe a bit of makeup. Looking good is a choice, you know.
Along with her two sidekicks, Amber and Jean.
Look, girls, the circus is in town!
In a way, Jean shared a lot of the same insecurities that Layla did and a lot of the same problems. She was a follower, so she wanted to feel safe in company, which was a popular company.
But you really want to do something with your hair, Jean.
Oh, yeah, I was just trying something out. I don't think she was very happy with the people she was with either. She was just trying to fit in just as much as everyone else was in the play.
Still going for the
look, Layla. Still failing to deal with your insecurities, Lucy.
But that only antagonises them, and they'll get you back in worse ways.
Trouble finding your lunch, Layla?
Throughout the play, they spend their time planning on killing her bully, who's called Lucy.
I don't know what to do, Layla. I've told my parents, the teachers. My counsellor said she'd report it, but no one's cared. Lucy just gets away with it because she's pretty and her dad's rich and all that. It's not fair.
We could kill her.
Yeah, right.
And how they're going to use one bullet to shoot her.
All working fine. You got the bullet?
Yeah.
Shouldn't we take more? Just in case?
No, we only need one. Makes it more symbolic.
Are we really doing this then?
Looks like it. How are you feeling about it?
Good. One bullet, Layla. Just one bullet.
Towards the play, we see that Oliver betrays Layla. Apparently, he's been seeing Jessica, which is her best friend. And Layla found this out through a text on the phone.
I mean, who does that? Pretends to be somebody they're not just for attention.
You mean she's not a lesbian?
No, at least not exclusively.
She likes boys.
Doesn't she, Oliver? I saw the text she sent you and the entire thread. Left little to the imagination. Made it clear that Jess was not only interested in girls, but in boys too.
Since she obviously knows my password to my phone, she opened it and saw the message, and from there she started plotting about wanting to kill me as well as her best friend and the bully, Lucy.
You were after him?
Is that why you changed the day? Layla, is that why you changed the day?
And she plots on killing me, Lucy, her best friend and her boyfriend, all with one bullet. So we don't really know who she's going to kill because she has one bullet.
From the beginning of the play, we make it clear that only one shot has been fired, and yet there are three potential victims. And so the point of the play, I suppose, is to keep the audience guessing as to who the actual victim is.
Showtime.
Miss Lewis.
Layla.
Layla.
Hi, guys.
What is it, freak? And where's Miss Lewis?
There's no Miss Lewis. Just me.
What's going on, Layla?
Layla,
I have you all exactly where I want you.
What are you talking about? Get out of the way and let me go home.
Layla,
you're not going anywhere. You're staying right here.
And between the three of them, they put Layla in a very difficult position where she's really struggling to deal with the life that's unraveling around her.
You have all destroyed my life. You have crumbled my hopes and you have shattered my dreams. You have exposed me to the nastiness of humankind and you have killed my faith in others. And you will go on to live the rest of your life completely unaware of the misery you have caused. It is not right, and it is not just, and I will refuse to let it happen. I will mark you with the guilt of everything you have done. That's my plan. One bullet.
Layla, put the gun away!
It's not what we planned, Layla!
What are you doing, you crazy bitch? Help! Somebody help!
And we tried to look at the different motivations. We tried to understand a little bit of the psyche of this particular person.
Those who are just trying to make sense of the confused chaos that is the world we live in. For us teenagers, life becomes one angry call at a universe that doesn't understand us, that doesn't take notice of us. And as we try to work everything out,
Our frustration fires question after question at anyone who will listen. And I guess that no one ever gave me an answer.
But they got that in way! What are you doing? Help them! Get help! What are you doing? Put the gun down! What are you doing? Just put the gun down! Help somebody! What are you doing? They got away!
Building up the character of Layla was really fun. I can relate to her character quite a lot because I'm 16, she's 16. We're both teenagers. And when I first read the scripts, I felt a lot of sympathy towards Layla because, you know, her best friend, you know, goes off with her boyfriend and it's really hard for her. But as I started doing rehearsals for the play, I started to feel that Layla wasn't as nice as I thought she was. And I started to portray Layla as more of a character that people disliked because I find that she's a bit selfish, you know. Yeah, her best friend's gone off with her boyfriend and yeah, she has bullies, but a lot of teenagers experience that. And she decides to, you know, be selfish and just kill herself. So I found building up the character, I decided to portray Layla as more of a character that people wouldn't like, maybe feel a bit of sympathy with, but dislike more than, you know, really like.
Seems to me like they want us to be afraid, man. Maybe we just like being afraid. Maybe we just so used to it at this point that it's just a part of us, part of our culture. Security alert on orange. It's been on orange since 01, G. I mean, what's up, man? Can a brother get yellow, man? Just for like 2 months or something? Goddamn. Sick of that. Mic check. The groove is thick, so I'ma rhyme like a lunatic. I do this shit with an unassuming wit. The corporation conjured up the bass and the tempo. My name is Liv, that's the intro, now let's go. The flow of life, throwing strife into the mix, to depict our condition in the